Hello there. We're about to share with you a case study that was put together by the HP Lizard Project Consortia. This is a reflection of the project. In their words, it has not been scripted by the APC, influenced or directed. It is their reflection on the project. What this case study shows us is how powerful collaboration is, how bringing together multiple partners is so much stronger than an individual partner doing this on their own. And we should recognise that thanks to the support from UK government, this collaboration can take place. Without such support, the collaboration of this nature just won't happen. And finally, it's worth reflecting that the technology developed in this project, which will be realised in mass market, help us all develop solutions for a cleaner, greener mobility future.
Sustainability is extremely important, and we are all on the road to net zero emissions. And on the other hand, we have products that are in the area of high performance. So we wanted to find solutions that combine those both worlds, delivering performing aspect, but doing that in a sustainable way. The APC6 project was about delivering high power optimized battery systems. The initial idea to start the project was based on a relationship that BMW had with McLaren, and both OEMs were on their journey to low carbon emission vehicles, and both companies have in common that they develop high performance powertrains. Both companies had the same needs and interests, so they joined forces and set up a consortium that will help them on their journey. When we won the bid for APC6, it was a really exciting moment. The companies worked really, really hard to win that bid, and it was for us the opportunity to finally start a collaboration between really exciting partners. Throughout the collaboration time with our partners, we got to know many new UK companies that we haven't worked with before.
Delta were really keen to be involved in the project. We were brought in as an SME, and we really wanted to build our relationships with companies like BMW, McLaren, and to further the existing relationship we had with WMG. The grant funding allowed us to develop much, much further than we would typically be able to on our own investment. So we've now progressed within a very short period of time our own capability. We hadn't previously worked with BMW, and we're really keen to have links in with McLaren as well, and building upon the existing relationship we had with WMG.
We have developed three pouch battery modules, one of which has been made into two packs running into BMW demonstrator vehicles, and another is being used by all teams in the British Touring Car Championships. One of the project goals was power density, and we've achieved an improvement of 5 times from 1 kilowatt per kilogram up to 5 kilowatts per kilogram for the latest module.
The impact from APC6 for Delta has been really crucial in us winning other commercial work. So all of the learning that we've generated within the project is going to feed into that work.
At WMG, we do a lot of industrial related research projects. In specific with the APC6 project, we've used the Energy Innovation Centre, which is one of Europe's largest battery cell development and test facility. We help steer our research in regards to our industrial partners' needs that hopefully they can then exploit with our future customers and current customers.
In this particular project, when you look at the project partners involved, the automotive end users, it really ticks boxes for me in that we get to bring new technology, able to drive research forward, but in a very applied fashion.
So to get the funding was just brilliant. That allowed us to employ some really great researchers at WMG, and allowed us to focus on one question, which was to answer the question with regards to high power cells.
So we mainly looked at optimising the slurry formulation, and then the other side of it was also looking at the sort of cell design aspects.
We're very happy with the achievements that we got out of this project. In particular, our development on the power cell, where we're able to show large jumps actually in performance on the discharge capability of the cells over the course of the project.
So the processes we have at WMG will be able to directly align with the industry standard. This means we'll be able to take our formulation that we developed in the project and place it straight into a larger scale manufacturing centre such as the UK Battery Industrialisation Centre. Well, without the funding, we wouldn't have been able to employ as many people onto the project to work on making the pouch cells. And we've managed to gain a lot of experience in specifically in high power cell building.
So with this being a large interdisciplinary project, this has also allowed some significant interactions with the OEMs, BMW, Delta Motorsport and McLaren. It's been very interesting seeing the ways that they work and educating us about best practices within the industry. And also likewise, we've also hopefully educated them about some of the performance properties of these batteries that they might not get from other cell manufacturers.
It's just been great working with the partners, both BMW and McLaren and Delta Motorsport, a great team of people. It's been really good fun.
WMG, the Warwick Manufacturing Group, developed in-house power cells. These cells could compete with the top three cell supplier cells out there on the market.
Williams Advanced Engineering's role in the project was to deliver specific engineering tasks around battery technology. They were predominantly in the area of immersive battery cooling to deliver superior cooling performance.
When BMW first proposed this immersion cooling system, we were really excited for the challenge that was going to come. We like working with novel ideas and working with innovative design solutions. So this was a great opportunity for us. We had a few challenges when developing this immersion cooling system. We managed flow and temperature distribution, as well as preventing leakage and being mechanically reliable while all capturing that high cooling capability was something that we pushed towards. We pushed the boundaries by looking into alternative cooling methods that is beyond the current industry standard. We managed to significantly increase the battery cooling power that allowed us to increase the overall battery power delivery as well as the safety by rejecting heat in a much more fast and even way.
We found the collaboration really positive. We found it very forward thinking, but also it was very positive to look at some of the future technologies and weigh up their feasibility in the consumer passenger car market.
It was a pleasure working with BMW. We continuously bounced off ideas with each other and pushed forward with our innovation. So overall, a very positive experience.
So we have gained a greater knowledge and understanding of premium OEM operations. We are growing the relationship with BMW, looking at future collaboration opportunities.
We wanted to be involved in the project. Obviously, electrification is a hot topic worldwide. This was a great opportunity to work together with BMW and other key players in this area. From a TWI perspective, we felt that we could add value with our multidisciplinary expertise. High voltage handling is not trivial, requires a lot of safety awareness, attention to details. Also, we try to make sure a robust process could be developed. There has been a great collaboration within the partnership, so a lot of knowledge transfer and collaboration and flexibility, they were crucial in this activity.
In this project, what we've really done is we've taken what we know, which is laser welding, and we've developed it and applied it to the specifics of BMW's products, so that the welds that we're putting into their products meet all of the criteria that they need to meet and that we can guarantee that they meet those criteria time and again. As a result of the collaboration that happened in this project, we've come a lot closer to BMW than we were before and developed a good rapport with them. I would say friendly, but at the same time critical as we go up the learning curve of productionizing a process. It's been very useful to have BMW's expertise in that respect.
When we started with the APC6 program, we intended to deliver one battery system for multiple architectures. But it turned out that we delivered three individual products at the end. Let's start with the McLaren Speedtail program. Project target was to deliver a battery pack that delivers 5 kW per kilogram. The key output of this program for McLaren was an extremely high power dense battery pack with 5 kW per kilogram, which is class leading. It takes 13 seconds to go from 0 to 300 kph. Then we have the fuel cell BX5 program. We managed to integrate an extremely small power dense battery pack just underneath the trunk floor, and it doesn't compromise any passenger comfort but still delivers 150 kilowatts in a package that is a bit more than two shoeboxes in size. In addition, we delivered battery packs for fully electric demo cars. And everybody who drove that cars had a big smile on his face. It's just stunning how these electric cars can accelerate. The project turned out very successful, and we could generate a lot of worthwhile IPs for the involved businesses. Working in the APC6 consortium was really, really good fun for everybody involved. It's quite unusual that you work with another OEM, an academic partner, a SME company on the same eye-to-eye level, open door, open book, bringing engineers together. That was really exciting. And seeing how people interacted, helped out each other, was really exciting to see. Now that the project has ended, on the one hand, I'm a bit sad that the close collaboration with this consortium is over. But on the other hand, I'm really happy to have met all these people, and I'm sure that we will continue working with each other the one way or the other. And I'm really proud that we delivered world-class performance battery systems.